During autumn and going into the winter months, it's really important that we target quality silverfish. On commercial fisheries, it's vitally important that they form part of your match plan. I'm at Larford Lakes today on the Specimen Lake, and I'm going to show you how I go about targeting these quality silverfish. On big open water commercials, like here at Larford today, one of my favourite tactics is the ground bait feeder, and I'm going to run you through the baits and the terminal tackle that I use to target these quality fish. Ground bait choice today on a commercial fishery has to be fish meal. Today I'm going to be using Sonu baits 50-50 method and paste mixed in an equal part with F1 dark. It's a nice dark mix, and at this time of year and as the water's getting clearer, it is essential that we use a dark or a very black mix. Right, I've mixed my ground bait up and I've put it into one of these EVA bowls. Now this is just for storage and it's on a pretty dry side. And then what I do is I have a second bowl, what I call my feed bowl, and I'll put a handful of the dry ground bait mix into the bowl and add my loose feed, my micro pellets and my dead maggots and my chopped worms as I see fit, a little bit at a time. And what it allows me to do as well is, as well as varying the amount of loose feed in the ground bait, I can also wet the ground bait up so it's a slightly wetter consistency. And I can vary between a dry consistency and a wet consistency during my match and see what the fish respond to best. What I'm going to include in my loose feed today in my ground bait is thin perfect micro pellets, dead red maggots and worms. I'll chop a few worms up, but I won't put them all in to start with. To start with, I'm just going to add a few micro pellets and a few dead maggots and see what response I get. If the response isn't so good, then I'll start to introduce a few chopped worms. Hook baits for today, my starting point is going to be double dead red maggot. If it's really hard, I can fish a single dead red maggot. If it gets good, I can put a big worm on, or I can put some F1 corn on. With worms and corn, I'm going to hair rig both of them, looking for a bonus fish, a big bream, or even a bonus carp. Terminal tackle for today. I've got an 11'6" superior rod. It's got enough casting power, but it's a lovely soft tip action for when you hook a nice skimmer, a bonus bream, or even a big carp. It's combined with a Centris 420 size reel, loaded with 6-pound sinking feeder model. And combined together, in my eyes, it's the perfect combination for what we're looking at catching today and the distance we're fishing at. The feeder itself is a 40 gram medium size distance cage feeder. I've got a twizzled boom, and then I've got a 40 centimeter hook length of 013 reflow power and a size 16 PR434 hook. It might seem a little bit heavy for skimmers, but there's every chance we can hook a bonus carp, so I feel this gives me just that added little bit of strength to be able to land a bonus carp should I hook one. Tactics for today, I've picked two lines, one at 50 metres and one at 25 metres. I'm going to use the same rod and reel setup for both lines. I'm clipped up at 50 metres, and what I've done is I've marked the line with a white crayon at 25 metres. So if I want to go on my 25 metre line, I simply wind back in and use the second line clip on this Centris reel, and I can clip it up at that, and I can move between the two lines using the same setup throughout the day. I'm fishing about 50 metres to start with. Prior to putting the hook length on, I've put about 6 feeder fulls of bait in, so I've accurately cast to my far bank marker. I've hit the clip each time, nice and comfortably and accurately, and I'm confident we're going to get a few pulls, so let's get it out there. Whenever you're feeder fishing, and it doesn't matter really whether it's a ground bait feeder or a method feeder, what you've got to bear in mind is you're always setting a trap for the fish. And everything has to be right. So we've gone through the terminal tackle today and we know that's right. So we've cast in, we've feathered it, the line down, we've hit the clip, everything's landed right, we've felt the feeder at the bottom, and we've carefully sunk the line, not moving the feeder. So we've put the rod under the water and we've wound very slowly. Some people prefer to pull the line, I prefer to just wind it very slowly. And I watched the line across the lake, you can see the line slowly sinking. And you just watch it and you keep your rod under the water until the line is completely sunk. Then you put your rod in the rod rest and just tension the tip nice and gently. So once it's nicely settled, it's just about keeping an eye on the tip, and watching for liners all the time. Liners, signs of bites, positive pulls. I had a little indication then. Hopefully it's going to materialise into a proper bite. I've been fishing about 30 minutes now, and it's best to be patient at the start of the match. Feel your way into it, just cast in nice and steady about every 5 to 10 minutes, putting a bit of bait in and letting your peg settle down. It's a cold morning, and I always think sometimes it can take half an hour to an hour for your peg to get going. So it's better to be patient rather than go a bit gung-ho and put too much bait in at the start. Just feel your way into it. Bites that I'm getting have been reasonably good pull rounds on the rod. You know when you've got a fish on. My setup, I prefer to use a fixed rod rest, a small one, when you're sitting and waiting for bites. You're not having to pull the rod, so you're just, you know, just waiting for the rod to pull round nice and steady. I expect to get a few bonus fish throughout the day, the odd carp in it, and providing you take your time on the setup we've got, we should be able to catch them no problem. Skimmers are ranging from a small one will be a pound, and a big one, you know, it's a bream when it's getting towards 3 pound. And it's just nice steady away fishing, and it can often be good tactics in the middle of the match. You can often target carp at the beginning, first hour, and sometimes the last hour. But in the middle of the match, when things generally go very quiet, providing you've baited your swim up at the start, this can be a great tactic. It can often put 10, 20 pound of fish in the net when others are sat waiting for bites off carp that aren't going to come. Right, there's a sign. Just pull the rod a little bit. There we go. There's a fish on. Just wind down to him. Feels like a nice skimmer. And the secret's just to keep a little bit of tension in the rod, just so he's nodding away. But the line's not too slack that he's got a chance of coming off. This nice steady pressure. Here he comes. Nice skimmer. Not the biggest, but a beauty nevertheless. There we go. Take the hook out, nicely hooked in the lip. Pop him in the net. Right, got another fish on now. It's getting towards the end of the session. It feels a decent fish, a bonus type fish. It's nodding about a bit. It's about 3 rod lengths out now. I'm just trying to make my mind up what he is. I think it's a decent skimmer. Yeah, feels it. Lovely bend in that rod. Look at the action on that rod. Beautiful. Oh, look at that. What a skimmer. He's a beauty. We've got him. Lovely skimmer. There we go. Last fish of the day. Beautiful skimmer. About 2 pound. Got a bit of a belly on him. Just take the hook out. Nice and gentle with him. What a beauty. Last fish of the day. Let's have a look what we've caught. Here we are, end of the day. These are what I've managed to catch. It's not been the easiest today, but there's 30 pound plus of big skimmers in here. Hopefully some of the tips I've given you will help you think about your fishing and help you catch some of these through the winter months.